represent North Liverpool Academy. Education is promoted to us as the integral preparation needed to become competitive and successful in the world of work. But is our education system effective in providing this? The short answer is no. A recent report ranked the United Kingdom 20th in the world for the standard of education it provides. The same report also showed that 20% of all British students leave education without acquiring the basic skills needed to enter full-time employment, meaning one-fifth of all pupils are failed by the system. Surely this shows that fundamental change is rapidly required. As a nation, we are one of a handful of countries that start compulsory education at the age of 5. Interestingly, none of the top 10 ranked countries, including Singapore, Hong Kong, Japan and Finland, start at this age, and in fact start at the age of 6 or even 7. These figures show that although we start education earlier than most other countries, we still fail to make the top 10 for the standard of education we provide. So are we simply pushing too much too young of our students? On average, in the first term of primary school, a British child asks 90% less questions than they did before starting school. We are systematically killing the curiosity of all students that enter our education system because education has become teaching to test and not teaching to learn. Teachers are now teaching the content of their courses under strict time constraints, which does not allow for the development of curiosity and other vital skills. Forcing knowledge upon children to regurgitate in examinations does not equate to effective learning or effective teaching, and ultimately demotivate pupils. For example, by the time British students and other European students finish secondary education, they have a similar reading capability, yet the enjoyment British children receive is far less than other European countries. However, teaching in this way has become increasingly necessary due to excessive government targets and due to the implementation of performance-related pay. Schools are ranked nationally based on the academic attainment of their pupils and not on the development of soft skills or skills that make a student more employable. Therefore, schools do not prioritise the softer skills, which is part of the reason why 20% of students leave education without developing skills. If we do not find a way to measure the development attainment of softer skills, then they will never become a focal point of education, meaning that education will never truly be what we are told it is. The UK is also subject to a teacher retention crisis, with 53% of all teachers considering leaving the profession due to the sheer volume of their workload and due to wanting a better balance between work and their personal lives. This has caused a considerable amount of good and outstanding teachers to quit. If you are demotivating the workforce who will provide the education to such an extent that they want to quit, how can we expect the recipients of the education to be motivated enough to overcome this and succeed? If teachers lose their ability to inspire, then the quality of teaching will rapidly decline at a faster rate than it currently is. I'll leave you with a quote by William Arthur Ward. He said, "The mediocre teacher tells, the good teacher explains, the superior teacher demonstrates, but the great teacher inspires."